Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. There's a charming old wives' tale that suggests the last thing a dying man sees will remain imprinted on his retina forever after. Let us suppose that the dying man in question is the victim of murder. It is perfectly reasonable to assume, is it not, that the last thing he sees would be his killer. Those of you with some knowledge of sunny Beverly Hills may recognize the locale, the Century Plaza Hotel's Hong Kong Bar. The year is 1961. Mr. Larry Keating's hands float over the keyboard of a piano. Behind him, his quintet all ready to start.
When the lady over there tries a match or gives up smoking, when the gentleman there gets the punchline, if he's got one, and that married couple, from the tone of voice, I'd say 12 years, decide how dry the martini, how high the moon, we'll be delighted to begin the begin, but not before. Love that silence. Man, let's break it.
The Blind Man, a screenplay by Ernest Lehman and Mark Gatiss, adapted for radio by Lawrence Bowen. In the semi-darkness, a short, grey-haired man materializes at Larry's side to escort him away. This is his manager, Morty Levitt. With his hand at Larry's elbow, Morty leads him through the club and across the lobby towards an elevator.
What's the rush, Morty? I was going to throw him an encore.
Don't let him eat Muzak.
Mr. Keating, can I have your autograph? Do you mind?
Please, young lady.
Oh, sure. Come on.
Morty takes the pad and pen from the girl and shoves them into Larry's hands. He signs his name without even looking down.
There you go.
Gee, thanks.
Don't thank him. Just buy his new album.
I got it already. It's real groovy, Mr. Keating.
Well, buy another. The grooves wear out.
You got a visitor.
Oh?
How you feeling?
I don't like that kind of question. Is it Sandra?
Sandra? When a girl like that says she's blowing, she's blown. You'll never see her again.
I want it in writing. All right, who?
They step into the rear of an elevator. Overhead lights glint in Larry's dark lenses. The operator closes the door. They walk into Larry's opulent hotel suite. Inside is a lean, handsome, silver-haired man. This is Dr. Daniel McGraw.
Larry.
Mac the knife.
How are you?
Larry takes off his sunglasses. For the first time, we see his opaque, sightless eyes, white as the berries of a mistletoe.
Look, Dr. Dan, before you say a word, the answer is no. Not interested. Change my mind.
Accident case. In Pasadena this afternoon. Both eyes perfect. Blood type so close to yours, the only thing closer would be an identical twin. They're in the eye bank, with my name on them. Ready to go first thing in the morning.
Jesus.
If I can get you to the hospital tonight.
I got a midnight show.
After the show.
I already told you.
I know. Morty, what time does the last show end?
1:05.
Right. No encores tonight.
I got a commitment. 3 more weeks.
It's all arranged. You got hepatitis.
Morty?
Dave Brubeck steps in tomorrow.
Listen to me, both of you. I'm okay. I'm better than okay. I'm loaded. I'm healthy. I got all the women I want. I'm the best goddamn jazz musician in the world. What the hell do I have to see for? Feels good here in the dark. I know my way around in it. It's good. You hear that, Mac? I like it this way. I'm happy. I've always been happy. Also, I'm scared. Jesus, am I scared. Morty.
I'm right here, kiddo. Why would I leave?
It is now the next morning. In the operating theater, Dr. McGraw is performing surgery on Larry's eyes. Very briefly, we see the transplant eye, first floating in a solution, then resting on a sterile pad. The operation is long and McGraw sweats, drinking water constantly, letting an assistant mop his beady forehead. That night, Larry lies in bed in his hospital room, eyes heavily bandaged. An attractive young honey-haired nurse, Miss Jenny Stiles, moves quietly to the bedside and looks down at him. She turns as the door opens and Dr. McGraw walks in. He is now in street clothes.
How are we doing, Jenny?
We're waking up nicely, thank you.
Larry? This is Dan. Can you hear me?
I'm the rocks with a twist.
Larry, this is Dan.
Make it a double. J and B is fine.
Alcohol and immunosuppressives don't mix well.
Why'd she introduce him? Give me a belt.
Say hello to Jenny.
Oh, Jenny.
Hello, Mr. Keating.
Who's Jenny?
Vice President in charge of immunosuppressives and anything else you might need.
Straight scotch, Jenny. You can forget the ice.
Sorry, Mr. Keating.
Good night, Jenny. Bitty bye, Jenny. Nighty night, Daniel. Sleep.
He's out again. When am I going to stop worrying about this guy?
He's going to be fine, Doctor. He's going to be one of the great voyeurs of our time.
It is now 4 weeks later. Dr. McGraw pulls shut the drapes of Larry's hospital room, wiping out the view, darkening the room.
Okay.
Larry is seated in a straight-backed chair. He is in slacks, loafers, and an open-collared shirt, his eyes still wrapped in bandages.
Go.
Jenny starts to unwind the gauze. Dr. McGraw moves to Morty's side, watching and trying to contain his nervousness.
How about a little striptease music, Morty?
How about holding real still?
Obviously, I'm not the first man you've undressed.
Wishful thinking?
I don't know why you're doing this. I am clearly marked, do not open until Christmas.
Oh, we couldn't wait to see what was inside.
She gets down to the last layer of gauze now and pauses.
Larry, keep your eyes closed.
They're not mine, but okay.
Dr. McGraw nods to Jenny. She unwinds the last layer of bandage, tosses it aside, and steps back. Larry's eyelids tremble slightly. Morty puts a hand over his own mouth to stifle it out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.